At the last renovation, there was 104 heirs for the house, so it was very difficult for them to share the house. Mr. Jacques de Maroussin, who is the actual owner, he decided to make the house a museum. So opened to the public in 1986, still private, nobody live in the house now. Okay. So apart from the museum, we use all the veranda for restaurant. As you can see, we put table there, and the veranda goes all around the house. We make here typical Creole lunch. It's make also an area of 1,000 square meter with the first floor. Upstairs has two big rooms. It was used as dormitories for the children, as they got 17 children. Here now, we've got in all 10 rooms that we visit. All the house is open to the public. So the furniture that you will see are all from the 18th and 19th century. Here, this is a music sitting room, the piano coming from Paris, se playel, the gramophone, and all these furniture from the East Indian Company, made with palisando wood. And some families, it's got the oven, where they use wood or charcoal as well. These are Japanese porcelain, the Mari, famous porcelain from Japan.
Si la photo est bonne, juste en deuxième colonne, y a le voyou du jour, qui a une petite gueule d'amour.
The Sugar Museum is an experience of the past. There are guided tours throughout the museum so you can learn the history of the making of sugar.
And we have to mix it with lime to separate the juice and the mud. And then when it is separated, these impurities, we use it as natural fertilizer. Afterwards, the remaining juice, we have about 80%, we have the water and the juice. And we have to separate the water and the juice.
Okay. No, you put sugar in?
Yes. Yes.
Je n'avais jamais ôté mon chapeau devant personne. Maintenant je rampe et je fais le beau.
They use commodes to store sugar. The museum is filled with the history of the sugar trade.
Dans sa menotte, j'avais des dents de loup, je les ai changées pour des quenottes.
Here, we separate the juice and the water.
This is Grand Bay, a small village town on the island of Mauritius where you can walk and walk and shop and shop.
Never thought that fairy tales come true, but they come true when I'm near.
Fruit in Mauritius melts in your mouth. These fishmongers on the beach are cleaning and selling fresh fish. The Grand Bay Bazaar is where you can drop your last dime.
In fact, the Rapam was the first living hotel of the world in the Indian Ocean 20 years ago, and we are very proud to belong to this fantastic company.
Well, the Rapam has one of the best locations on the island, located in the northwest part of the island, which is one of the most protected places, just a few minutes walking distance from Grand Bay, which is the little Saint-Tropez of Mauritius. The Royal Palm is one of the smallest hotels, the smallest property on the island. And we do have 84 accommodations, 57 junior suites and 27 other types of suites. starting from 55 square meters until 350 square meters concerning the royal suites. All the spa activities, different types of massage, treatments, fitness room, hammam, sauna. Well, this is another magical aspect of the island. All this melting pot, all these people living together. You've got different community, the Indian, the Creole, the white Mauritian, and also the Muslim community. And it is true that for me this is a unique place in the world where all these people can live in harmony and in peace, which is an example for all of us. The people, you know, are very interested to visit Grand Bay, but also most of them are going to Port-Louis to have an idea of what the old city was and the new Port-Louis is, because you've got the old part of the capital and the new part, the modern one. But also most of them are interested to visit the Botanical Garden, which is located in Pamplemousse, about 10 minutes driving distance from the hotel, which is a huge and fantastic garden when you can have all the types of trees and plants which are existing in Mauritius.